All right, you haven't watched the previous videos, go watch them before you can't pick up here, okay? But we're using a little bit of tap magic right here. I'm just gonna put it down inside the hole because we're about to ream this this bad boy out. All right, now we're gonna take off about 5,000 worth of material. And once again, I kind of think that maybe this spike should have been reamed at the factory, was prepared to be reamed, and maybe they didn't remember it and it ended up in a box. Regardless, we want to set a little bit of spring tension right here. Now, I use this tool pretty frequently, but by all means, look at the Park Tool manual to learn how to do it. Don't learn it from me necessarily right now. But we're going to start reaming at this time. All right, it's gonna really want to bite in because 5,000 is a lot of material. The important thing to do is to be very fluid with your movements, okay? Because as you see, the spring pressure is dragging it right in, right? It's almost home right now. So we already measured this. We measured this ream. We know it's gonna do 40.98. So we're gonna be good to go. And that is actually done. Look at that. No muss, no fuss. Now when you're taking it apart, I want you to go ahead and turn it backward, okay? We wanna turn it backward because it doesn't cut in that direction. We don't wanna accidentally cut material as we're removing it, because you can. So what I'm going to do, move my arm so you can see what's going on here. This is the tricky part, getting it out. And normally, I mean, this is the way Park Tool sets up this ream, unfortunately. Normally what you would want, look at all this material. Look at all that material. How could that bottom bracket ever be any good? All right, now let's look in the hole, see what we got. Well, hold on a sec. Don't go reaching your fingers in there to pull chips out. Could be bad. Could end up cutting yourself. All right, and let's see. So we're gonna go ahead and look in there, and so we'll look at the surface. It's not the most, it's not the most perfect surface, but it is the correct size, and we're gonna go ahead and we're going to confirm that we are at our target measurement, and we are. We're right about 40.97, 40.98. It's gonna give us excellent fit when we go to put this BB Infinite module in just a second.